the art is to break the bad eating habits of children. In today's world, there are several working couples who both the husbands and the wives are busy with their careers. They suffer from a lack of time and spend several hours working late in the office. As a result, the children resort to eating unhealthy fast food. They accumulate several bad eating habits, which leads to issues like obesity. Our product Poshan caters to the upper middle class working couples. In these families, parents in their mid-30s have children in their preteens. This is a crucial time for both parents and children alike, because the parents are at the peak of their careers, climbing up the corporate ladder, and children require maximum nutrition. Our solution? Poshan. With love from one mother to another. It is a food delivery service that brings to your doorstep healthy, nutritious, home-cooked meals. What makes our product unique? Our cooks are all mothers and grandmothers. They are not commercial chefs, they are not culinarily trained, but we guarantee you healthy, tasty, home-cooked food. We want to bring back the nutritive Indian cuisine, as well as a range of other products made with local, organic produce. We want to break the mindset that eating healthy means eating not tasty. I will now hand over the presentation to Shivagama Sundari, who will elaborate on the salient features of Poshan.
Thank you, Pritika. Getting back to Poshan, our product is subscription-based, that is, the customers pay at the beginning of the month. It works on timetable basis, where the parents provide a schedule for the meals they want. We stay connected with our customers through our apps, which make it easier for the parents to subscribe, set a timetable, and cancel orders. We shall cancel order if informed 1 day in advance and compensate the meals in the consecutive months. The children have the option to choose from our vast, tasty and healthy menu made by our own loving chef. Our chefs are homemakers with lot of untapped potential. These people not only cook well but also pour a lot of love and affection. For this, we personally interview and handpick our chefs. We deliver to homes and also to schools at the request of the parents. We procure organic produce from our local farmers. We cater to a wide variety of customers, including vegan, vegetarian and gluten-free meals. For this, we have dietitians to approve our calorific value for the age-appropriate products. Tanvi will now elaborate on the business plan.
Thank you, Sugami. Poshan with love from one mother to another, prepared with care and affection. Initially, we plan to start with 5 chefs who are basically the homemakers. The delivery staff will supply the fresh produce to the homes of the chefs in the morning. The meals will be collected by the chefs, by the delivery staff, and they will be delivered to the customers as per the order. The chefs will then be paid as per the fuel and the time they spent on the meals. As we expand, we will take commercial kitchens on lease and then hire freelancers. And then we also plan on taking our franchise throughout the country. And let me get on with the challenges. Our business is mainly a low investment enterprise, and our major challenge is getting the kids to try our product for the first time and breaking the mindset that healthy means not tasty. This we plan on doing by offering them free samples for a brief time period, because we're sure that once they try our product, they get addicted to it. In case of a disruption in the supply chain, that is, if we don't get our produce for a brief period of time, we will offer an alternate dish or a compensatory meal on a later date. We will have inspections and regular checkups, and this is the profit forecast for the next 5 years, for the next 5 years, 15% to 20%. We are happy to take this opportunity to introduce the app that we have made for Poshan, and we will be delighted if the judges have time to view it. It is a trial version developed in the export tool, Swift programming language. It was professionally built with the help of my cousin's brother. Thank you.
very impressed, actually. I think all the kids deserve a very good round of applause for the effort they've gone into. They're making websites and apps. So, I just had a couple of websites. I founded a company which does something similar. And it's interesting to talk to some of the challenges of the ages, going from a home chef to scale. What do you think are the biggest challenges when you use home chefs?
So one problem that we have heard of is that this is there are low barriers to entry, which means after some time people can also start copying our product. So eventually we will face a decline in the profits that we start getting. Using home chefs, it's probably that they could cancel suddenly, but we have thought of it. We will start local, where we'll get a lot of women helpers in this enterprise. And if one person backs up, we have to split up the job amongst others.
Three people make the same dish, then the quality will be different. So the same customer gets it from different people.
Yeah, okay. So think about it this way. When you were a kid, you didn't like a certain food. I don't like a lot of food. So my mom comes up with innovative different ways to make the same thing so that I can eat it. So that is, do you think it's a disadvantage? It's actually an advantage. Because how many times have you looked at your friend's cover and actually liked the lunch better than your own? So the fact that every mom makes it different is an advantage.
Great answer, but I was asking slightly different. My question is, if you like pongal, for example, if three different people make pongal over 3 weeks, which is what you're saying, that you know, different home chef may be pulled in if somebody else is not available, then the same dish for me starts tasting different. I mean, like person one, not like person two. But I'm getting your product, I'm getting Poshan. There's an actual issue that we faced in these companies where you start expecting consistency in quality. Which is why I like the idea that you already thought about going to kitchens where you can mass produce and quality become more predictable. So I like the thought process and good answer.
What role do you see for e-commerce in this venture? Number one. What role, few of you, what is the role that you will pay given a money to start this business? So, for you, what is the role that you will pay?
The role we play is that.
I have a role of each one of you, what role would be? It is this enterprise. You are given money to start this business. So, what roles you will play, what roles you will play, what role you will play?
We are actually solving a major problem.
Oh no. What is the role of that company that you will start once you have given?
We are problem solvers. That's it, that we are providing. So we will look at personally picking chefs. And then you have to focus, we have to focus mainly on advertisement.
You will do what? You will do what? Does not succeed for 6 months, but doesn't have given. So what would you do next to raise the resources?
Okay, so because this works on a timetable basis, the people, they have to order at least 1 day in advance, right? So that way we can make sure that none of our produce goes to waste when we get it, because we are informed in advance and the produce will be delivered freshly in the morning. So that way we make sure that nothing goes to waste.
I think the question was, suppose you realize that the enterprise is not going in the direction the way you want it to go, then how will you think about reinventing yourself?
We'll concentrate on the areas which made us lose and also solve it.
Is home food especially is associated with stories, whereas if you just get it as food, you might as well be taking tablets or what should I say, just treat it as a task. How would you deal with that perception?
See, our target audience is actually really different, right? In the sense, it is for kids. It's when the parents are so involved with their careers that they are suffering from a lack of time while they can deliver food. So getting the home food itself is one step towards being healthier. And I understand what you're saying, but these kids, they don't usually get home cooked food, right? So it's one step in that direction, that getting tasty food. So.
That you are not doing the right thing. It's not a good way to communicate. If you tell parents that you are not giving your children good food and we will give them good food, parents will not like it. So you have to have a different way to communicate.
That's our tagline. The love from one mother to another. It's like one mother is understanding the situation of another, and it's not, she's not correcting her, she's supporting her, she's backing her up.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.